Malaria is very challenging because it's a very complex disease. You have the mosquito, you have the human host, and you have the parasite. And each of those variables can affect the process of malaria infection. It's one of the most devastating diseases in Africa and other parts of the world.
Burkina Faso is a West African country. And when you place Burkina on the map of Africa, you can see that Burkina is located under the tropic, in the tropical part of Africa. This is the place of a country where, you know, the climate condition is very favorable for mosquito. So we have in a place where the malaria transmission is permanent. The last report from the national the Minister of Health showed that in 2015 we have more than 2 million of cases of malaria that have been detected in the country.
We went to Burkina Faso to collect samples from children before infection, and we actually followed these children during the course of infection.
The study sites are about 500 kilometers from the capital, which is Ouagadougou. So we had to commute either by plane or taking cars for 7 hours.
It's very well known that some genetic factors of the host and of the parasite are involved and will change the severity. For example, you have some people who die from malaria, others survive, and among the people who survive from malaria, they experience a broad range of clinical variations.
We are very well equipped here at NYU Abu Dhabi, so we have approaches and methods that allow us to study both host and parasite at genome-wide level. So instead of focusing on one gene at a time or on a few genes, we can actually look at the entire genome of both host and parasites.
It's not only just analyzing a sample, we could put name behind this. And I think this was a great experience in that way.
It's always touching to work with those populations because we know that some of those kids might not survive the infection. The idea is really not just to do this kind of research, but also to be able to somehow give back to those communities.